वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल 24/7 एपी लाइब्रेरी। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कवर दीज टू पोएम्स लेजर एंड टुडे एंड टुमारो दैट आर ऑफ 6th क्लास ऑफ डीएवी स्कूल। लेट्स स्टार्ट। द फर्स्ट लिटरेरी डिवाइस इज Simile. Simile is a direct comparison between two things using the comparison words like or as. In simile, we use like or as word to compare two things. Like we have example from the Lazar poem, streams full of stars like skies at night. Here we have comparison between streams and stars using the word like. So this is simile. Another example, we have no time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. Here also we have comparison using the word as. So simile is a comparison using the word like or as. In simile we use comparison words. We have second literary device, metaphor. Metaphor is an implied comparison without the use of comparison words like or as. So this is also used to compare two things, but without the use of comparison words like or as. We don't use like or as words in metaphor. In simile we use these words like or as, but in metaphor we don't use these words, but both are used for comparison. Next is third literary device, that is alliteration. The occurrence of the same sound at the beginning of adjacent or closely connected words is called alliteration. Alliteration is the occurrence of same sound. Like we have example here from the Lazar poem, streams full of stars like skies at night. Here we have S sound repeated three times in the same line. Closely connected words means we have one or two words in between them. Like this example we are seeing, streams full of. Here we have two words gap in between these S sound repeated words, streams full of stars like skies at night. Another example we have, no time to see when woods we pass. Here a W sound is repeated three times in adjacent words. These are adjacent words, one after the other. In first example we have the alliteration in closely connected words. In second example we have alliteration in adjacent words, one after the other, continue words. W sound is repeated in continuous words. Another examples we have from the poem Today and Tomorrow. Let's do the deed today. Here we have D sound repeated two times in this line. Another example, who the future can foretell. Here we have F sound repeated two times in closely connected words. So this is alliteration. The use of alliteration gives a musical effect to the poem. So, alliteration is used to give the musical effect to the poem. And remember one thing, here in alliteration we see the occurrence of same sound, repetition of same sound at the starting letter of the word only. The beginning sound should be repeated, only then alliteration will be there. Next literary device which we have now, repetition. Repetition is a literary device used to repeat the same words, phrases, line or stanza to lay stress on something or to give musical tone to the poem. When same words, phrases, lines or stanzas are repeated in the same stanza, in same line, in same poem, then that will be repetition. Like we have example here from the poem Leisure. No time to stand beneath the boughs and stare as long as sheep or cows. No time to see when woods we pass, where squirrels hide their nuts in the grass. In this poem, Leisure, no time phrase is repeated many times. So this is repetition. Same word is repeated, same phrase is repeated many times in the poem Leisure. This is repetition. And the difference between alliteration and repetition is, alliteration is when the same sound is repeated at the beginning of the words. But repetition is when the words, phrases, line or stanza is repeated. Full word, full phrase, full line or full stanza is repeated, that is repetition. This is the difference. Be clear about the difference between alliteration and repetition. Next literary device which we have now, personification. Personification is a literary device used to show the human-like qualities in a non-living thing or to represent a non-living thing as a human being. Personification, when we show human-like qualities and in any non-living thing, that is personification. Like here we have the example from poem Leisure. No time to turn at beauty's glance and watch her feet, how they can dance. This is personification because Leisure poem is about nature, about the beauties of nature, and we are showing human-like qualities in non-living thing, that is nature. Watch her feet, nature has no feet. How they can dance, nature cannot dance. But we are showing these qualities in nature, that is a non-living thing, and we are showing human-like qualities in nature. So this is personification. When we show the qualities of any person in a non-living thing. Next is rhyme. When the last word of the lines in a poem show a similarity in sound. When we have rhyming words at the end of the lines of the poem, that is rhyme. We have examples from the Leisure poem. Care, stare, bows, cows, pass, grass, light, night, glance, dance, can, began. These are the examples from Leisure poem. These words are at the end of the lines in poem Leisure, and they are producing same sound, similar sound at the end of the lines. Another example we have from Today and Tomorrow, say today. These are also at the end of the lines of the poem Today and Tomorrow. Say today, wait late, today away, foretell well. These are rhyming words, and when we have rhyming words in a poem, that means that poem has rhyme literary device. Now, rhyme scheme. Rhyme scheme of the poem. How can we make rhyme scheme of the poem? How can we identify that rhyme scheme of the poem? See these lines which are on your screen. What is this life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. Against first line, we write A. Against first line, we write A. And against next line, we write same letter if we have rhyming word. Same as first line, similar word, rhyming word of first line is there at the end of second line. Then we use same letter. Like here, केयर एंड स्टेयर, दीज आर राइमिंग वर्ड्स. सो अगेंस्ट फर्स्ट लाइन वी राइट ए, एंड अगेंस्ट सेकेंड लाइन ऑल्सो वी राइट ए, बिकॉज दीज आर राइमिंग वर्ड्स. नो टाइम टू स्टैंड बनीथ द बाउज, दिस इज थर्ड लाइन, एंड दिस इज नॉट द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ फर्स्ट और सेकेंड लाइन, सो वी राइट नेक्स्ट लेटर बी. वेन वी डोंट हैव राइमिंग वर्ड वी यूज नेक्स्ट लेटर बी. एंड स्टेयर एज लॉन्ग एज शीप और काउज, काउज इज द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ बाउज, सो वी यूज सेम लेटर एज थर्ड लाइन बी. फॉर राइमिंग वर्ड्स वी यूज सेम लेटर्स. सो दिस इज द राइम स्कीम. द राइम स्कीम ऑफ दिस पोएम इज ए ए बी बी. अनदर थिंग विच यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, राइम स्कीम वी राइट इन कंटिन्यू लेटर्स ए ए बी बी विदाउट द यूज ऑफ कॉमर्स, विदाउट द यूज ऑफ कैपिटल लेटर्स. दिस इज द मेथड टू मेक टू आइडेंटिफाई द राइम स्कीम ऑफ द पोएम. अनदर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव फ्रॉम टूडे एंड टुमारो. डोंट टेल मी ऑफ टुमारो ए लेटर, बिकॉज हेयर वी विल स्टार्ट विद ए लेटर ओनली. गिव मी द मैन हु विल से, दिस इज नॉट द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ फर्स्ट लाइन, सो वी यूज नेक्स्ट लेटर बी. दैट वेन गुड डीड इज टू बी डन, दिस इज नॉट द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड लाइन, सो वी यूज नेक्स्ट लेटर सी. एंड नेक्स्ट लाइन लास्ट लाइन, लेट्स डू द डीड टूडे. टूडे इज द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ सेकेंड लाइन से, दिस इज द राइमिंग वर्ड ऑफ द एंड वर्ड ऑफ सेकेंड लाइन, सो वी यूज सेम लेटर एज वी हैव यूज्ड फॉर सेकेंड लाइन. सो हेयर ऑल्सो फॉर फोर्थ लाइन वी यूज बी, बी लेटर विल बी यूज हेयर, बिकॉज सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ लाइन हैव द राइमिंग वर्ड्स. एट द एंड ऑफ दीज लाइन्स राइमिंग वर्ड्स आर देयर, सो वी यूज बी लेटर फॉर बोथ. नाउ द राइम स्कीम इज ए बी सी बी, दिस इज द राइम स्कीम ऑफ दिस पोएम. दिस इज द मेथड टू आइडेंटिफाई द राइम स्कीम ऑफ एनी पोएम. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस एंड राइम स्कीम, हाउ टू आइडेंटिफाई राइम स्कीम ऑफ एनी पोएम, हाउ टू आइडेंटिफाई द लिटरेरी डिवाइसेस यूज्ड इन दैट पोएम. To subscribe our channel 24/7 AP Library.
For more updates, subscribe to our channel. Click the show links and enjoy watching the videos.